Hi guys and dolls, what is up? Well, as is the nature of being self-employed, I can do what I want to and not do what I want to. And today I did not want to do anything.
Pretty much.
Yesterday and today I've kind of been off a little bit. I don't know why, but I've been a little bit off. And so I thought I would just take a little bit of time to get outside and clear my head and do a mental walkabout. And we finally have some cloud cover.
What?
So that's kind of pleasant. And I have on no makeup because I don't care. So I hope I don't scare the little children while I'm out and about. But today is day 16? I think it's day 16 of 30 days of selling online. And I'm sure as y'all are aware, you're noticing that, and if you're actually going to my sites or whatever, I ain't getting a lot of sales. But like I said, it's July. And the reason I wanted to draw that to your attention was so there that, you know, again, my channel's all about getting real. And this is about getting real, you know. This is a project, 30 Day Selling Online, to kind of see how it's going to go, demonstrate to y'all what you can do. But as I've said through the whole thing, what I sell is going to be different than you sell. It's hard to compare a lot of times what my sales would or would not do compared to yours, but the information is all valid that I'm giving. How to source things, talked about it before, how to source things without spending money. Can you do it? Can you do it for free? I've talked about it in a lot of other videos, but I wanted to summarize it here. So, you can get stuff to sell. First of all, let go of the stuff you've got in your house. I get so incensed when I see people with so much stuff for nothing, how much money they wasted if they had invested that money in anything other than junk. So, if you fall in that category, get rid of your stuff. Okay, but moving on, where else can you find stuff? Now, I'm going to tell you right now, this is what I suggest. Can y'all even hear me? Has it gotten windy? I'm going to stop here for a minute. This is what I suggest, okay? It doesn't mean you should do it. If you're not comfortable doing it, don't do it. But I'm telling you, you can get stuff for free. So, as I've mentioned before, if you're out garage sailing or estate sailing or whatever, and it's the last day of their sale, you can ask them when is the last day to sale. And then ask them what they're doing with their stuff at the end of it. If they're just going to donate it or give it away, offer to haul it off for them for free. Don't charge them for it, and don't have them make you pay for it, okay? That's one way that you can get stuff for free. Okay, another way to get rid of stuff. And this, again, goes along the same lines of all my rants I've done about hoarding and everybody's got too much stuff and things like that. But here's the God's honest truth, okay? Can't believe this. I worked at Home Depot for 3 years, and I worked at Stein Mart for under a year. And I can personally attest and verify to the fact that, okay, first of all, number one, these two businesses are not alone, okay? But I can personally attest to the fact that they throw away, yes, throw away perfectly good merchandise just because it's a SKU that they've canceled using. Okay, it doesn't mean that the product is damaged necessarily. It doesn't mean that it's bad. And it doesn't mean that it's not beyond repair, that maybe you could repair it yourself. So, what does that mean? I'm not telling you to do it. I'm just stating a fact here. But retail stores have dumpsters behind them. And A lot of times there's not traffic around those dumpsters in the evenings or when the stores are closed, like if they're closed on Sunday. I'm just saying, you know, hopefully you are picking up what I'm throwing down here, but that's one way. I told you these were going to be a little bit random, these tips today. All right, along those same lines, there is what is called bulk trash pickup days. That is when people in different neighborhoods that have trash that come, you know, through the neighborhoods, they are able to put out things on their sidewalks, whether it's, you know, well, not grass clippings anymore, but, you know, whether it's some kind of yard rubbish or whether it's actually pieces of furniture they don't want. I've had people that I know of that have picked up rollerblades, tennis rackets, skateboards, bike helmets, bike pads, etc. Pieces of furniture, like I said. And all this is at bulk trash pickup day. Now again, I'm not saying you have to do it, I'm just stating that it's a fact. Free stuff on the side of the road. If it's out there already, it's free. Another thing, of course, is ye old Craigslist. Craigslist is a great source of literally free stuff. Go on to Craigslist in your local city. Look for free, I think it says free items or free things or just free, something like that. And look around and see what that is. And, you know, I'm begging you, please, unless it says on their thing, don't email them and say, is it still available? That is the ultimate in lazy. If someone has listed something for free, you need to get out. You need to get up off of your duff. You need to get out in your car with your addresses of all these free things. Drive around and pick them up. Don't waste time giving an email and then hoping they'll get back to you or giving them a phone call and then hoping they're going to get back to you. That's ridiculous. Don't do that. Okay? It's a waste of everybody's time. There's nothing that incenses me more because on my postings, now granted, you know, on my postings I do things a little different, but I tell them if the picture, if the ad is still up, it's still available. All right? But beyond that, it's free. Don't make it difficult on somebody else for them to give you something for free for you to turn around and to sell. Okay? If you don't think dumpster diving and stuff like that can make money, you need to go check out my video called Dumpster Dive Live, where you see I picked up 3 items one day, and literally the next day I sold them. I think it was for, was it $50? I think I sold them for $50 or $70 the next day. It was free. My labor that was involved was picking them up, putting them in my car, driving them home, and cleaning them off. Okay, so you can do that. Another thing besides the bulk trash pickup in neighborhoods is also apartment communities at the, like around the beginning or the end of the month. In other words, when people are moving out. Because a lot of times they don't want stuff like my dumpster. It's still there. I'm going to see if y'all can see it. Okay, can y'all see right there, right past my fingernail where that orange cone is? That, my lovelies, that is a giant television that still works. It says on there free. It still works. Set there by the side road. It's too heavy for me or else I'd pick it up and I have nowhere to put it. So I didn't pick it up. But because of the very fact that TV is there proves my point that when people are moving out from apartments, they are notorious. They're notorious for, you know, getting rid of stuff that they could either sell or take with them. So check out the dumpsters again at the beginning, around the beginning or the end of the month, okay? Now, another thing just about apartments in general, and I used to work in the apartment industry. I used to work for Lincoln Property Company. So I've had a very, very background. This is a long vlog. Deal with it. Sorry. But apartment offices, they have a problem when people skip on their rent or whatever, and, you know, there's a whole bunch of stuff left in the apartment because they had to get out fast because they didn't want to pay their rent. after a certain amount of time, those apartment communities basically own that stuff, and they can dispose of it how they want to. So right now, they're having to pay their own, you know, staff, their own maintenance staff, to deal with that stuff. Well, wouldn't it be lovely if you contacted some apartment communities? Not a ton of them. You don't need a ton. Don't be greedy. You can't manage that much stuff either on your own. Call those apartment communities and say, hey, I know that sometimes people skip out on their rent or whatever, and you're left with the burden of, you know, dealing with all the stuff that's left over. I'll come in and pick all that stuff up for you. You're not going to clean the apartment, you know, not like that. And if there's stuff in there that's too big or something that you don't want, call Salvation Army. Call Goodwill. You know, make it easy for them. And again, you don't charge them. They don't charge you. Everybody's happy. You can go on down the road. All those ideas come when I'm, you know, when my mind gets cluttered up and I need to get out and I need to get some fresh air, like I'm doing right now, being outside. Helps your mind start functioning. So do that the next time that you are knotted up and you can't figure out, you know, what you need to do to make some money or where you're going to find some stuff or how you're going to get things to sell. Actually, that's one of the reasons why I'm out here walking right now, is because as I mentioned to you at the beginning, my stuff isn't selling. I feel bad for you guys because you're not getting a real picture. You're not getting a real picture of what it's like, you know, selling online. But you kind of are too, because not every month is a good month. You know, not every week you're going to make money. Some weeks you're going to break even. Some weeks you're going to go in the hole. But it's just all part of it. And I'm balancing on the sidewalk. Another thing, whoa, as I said that, I'm falling off. Another thing I do, it's just, you know, this is just life, people. Don't take it so seriously. I know that's, for some of y'all, that you may think, well, that's easy for you to say, you know. A lot of you have no idea what my history is or what my life is like. So be careful what you say, unless you know who you're saying it about. This was kind of ranty. Sorry about that. But if you ever watched my video on my channel page, you know that I may get a little ranty sometimes. And so when people say that they don't know what to sell, or they don't know how to sell, it's windy again. Y'all may not can hear me. But if you figure out something to sell, I'm like, open your eyes. Free stuff is all around you. Abundance is everywhere. Quit having the lack mentality. Quit having the mentality of, oh my gosh, I lost my job. What's going to happen? Oh my gosh, this tragedy has befallen me. What am I going to do now? You know what you're going to do now? You're going to get up. You're going to pick yourself up. You're going to dust yourself off. But this time, you're not going to start all over again. This time, you're going to try something different. You're going to walk backwards instead of forwards. You're going to go upstairs instead of downstairs. You're going to turn left instead of right. So don't do what you've always done before. Think outside the box. Get creative. You're watching this video because you know you can do it, but you're afraid for some reason. So any of you that have been watching, we're on day 16 now. If you've been watching this whole time and you haven't listed your first thing, I challenge you to do it today. Don't hesitate. As soon as this video is over, go to Craigslist and post something. I say Craigslist because you don't have to set up an account to post on Craigslist. Well, I mean, you have to put in your name and stuff, but it's not any kind of big deal. Do it. I dare you. See what happens. So, on that, it's been long. Sorry. But it was necessary, and I was lazy, and had a mind clutter. So, y'all have a delicious, delightful, delirious day. Make a change, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.